This is going to be part two, and we're going to be using this angle grinder with a cutoff wheel to make a slit in this stripped out Phillips head screw to get this cover off. And nothing more about it, just stay with it. You might not be able to see it tomorrow, but just trust me. Safety first. Should be good. Now you can take your screwdriver, most likely with a wrench that you should have with you because it has a nut drive, you get more leverage. You can just go like this. Alright. This is not going to be as simple. Probably gonna fail again at getting this off. Most likely. Or I just might need a bigger flathead. Oh, because this one's twisting. I will be back cutting off. I am back with a bigger screwdriver. So hopefully, ooh, that's paint thinner. I didn't think that was still full. There's still that stuff in it. We're just gonna stick it on here. If you can't see that, oops, but if you can. Nice. Ah, it's so close. I can almost get it. Oh, it's coming undone. Finally. After all this time. Yeah, this screw is going to get replaced, or it's just cross-threaded too. I wonder, I bet you it is cross-threaded. You know, I should probably grab, what is it? Penetrating oil. Oops. Again, for the same another video in a row. I like that. Alright. So freaking hard. This has to be cross-threaded. Probably have to cut it again. Probably this way. That sucker's tough. Alright, goggles back on. I'm gonna cut this thing. That's all. Let's see. Take some more material off. Messed up. Why is this bolt in here? What if I turn it back? Yeah, it ain't going back. No. I wonder if I cut this bolt off, you know? I mean, yeah, we could get it out. I'd be able to get it out then. Let me just cut this off then. If I can get this